Welcome children. Now here we will discuss some more questions based on rational number. Today we will discuss how to sort the numbers in ascending or descending order. Also we will learn how to add the rational numbers. Now take the first question. It is sort it in ascending order. I hope you remember yesterday when we were comparing two numbers, we used to take LCM of the denominators and then convert it into equivalent fraction, and we saw they become like terms, and then we used to compare. So this time also ascending order also means comparison. The comparison is between three numbers. It can be between four numbers and many more. So the method will be same. The first step will be we will take the LCM of the denominator 6, 4 and 5. Let us take the LCM 6, 4 and 5. This will go by 2, 3s are, 2, 2s are and 5, 2, 1s are. And now you can take 3, 1s are. And lastly, 5, 1s are is 5. So what is the LCM? Check. 5 3s are 15, 15 2s are 30, 30 2s are 60. So we get the LCM as 60. The next step will be you take down these numbers right below each other, one below the other. You copy the numbers which were given and you compare it with the calculated LCM. In 6 table, when do you get 6? You get it in 10 times. So multiply with 10 at numerator also with this number, that is 2. 2 tens are 20. The same thing you will do for the other numbers also. The LCM what you have got, you will compare that number, the given number with the calculated LCM. In 4's table, when do you get 60? You get it in 15. 15 times 4 is 60. So here also you will multiply it with 15. So let us multiply 12 into 15. 5 is a 10 carry 1, 5 is a 5 and 6. Here it is 2 and 1. So the answer is 180. So 15, 12 times is 180. Move to the next one. In 5's table, when do you get 60? You get, see here, 12 5s are 60. You get it in 12 times. So multiply with the same number. So 12 3s are is 36. Check children, what is this? See the numbers. When you compare it with the LCM, you see you have multiplied and divided by the same number. See here also, multiplying and dividing by the same number. So when you multiply and divide by the same number, what do we get? We get its equivalent fraction. Now let me write down these numbers. What we have got? 20 by 60, 180 by 60 and 36 by 60. Let me rub this part. You have to show the rough work also with pencil. Remember. So now see. Once we converted this into equivalent fraction, now we see they are in like terms. So now when they are in like form, it is easy to compare. The D is same. Check the numerator. Whichever numerator is smaller, that number will become smaller. Then you have 36 upon 60. And the last one is 180 upon 60. That's not all. So 20 by 60, the original fraction you see, it is representing which one? 20 by 60 means 2 by 6. This is smaller than the next one was 3 by 5. And the last one is 12 by 4. So here we get the answer. So what we have to do, whenever you have question, in terms of comparison of the rational numbers. So remember, whenever you have questions on comparison, on addition or subtraction. For these three questions, you always take the least common multiple. The LCM what you get, you compare it with each number. Then you get it in equivalent form. And when you once compare it with the LCM for all the three numbers, you will see the answer what you get after converting it into equivalent fraction are now in like form. And then you solve it. Take for example, in this question, here the question was write down in ascending order. Suppose the question was to add the following. Still here the steps will be same. Only when you get the LCM and get it in like form, instead of commas, you rewrite these numbers, put a plus sign and add the numbers. So here it will become 60, 20 plus 180 plus 36. Now check, 180 plus 20, 200. 200 plus 36, the answer is 236 upon 60. And because it is an improper fraction, you can convert it into mixed fraction. Isn't it so easy? We are simply having a practice session of this chapter. Nothing is new. You have to add, you take the LCM. You have to solve where you have done. If the question is to solve where you have both addition and subtraction. So you will do the same thing. Take the LCM, compare with the LCM. You see they will be in like terms. Rewrite the answer after converting it into equivalent fraction again. And whatever is given, take for example here the question was, suppose solve and it was plus and minus. What are you going to do? Same thing till here, the method is same. Only here you write down minus. Then you write down here also minus. So 180 plus 20 is 200. And 200 minus 36, you get it as 461. So the answer is 164 upon 60. See, so easy it is. So just try some questions, children, on your own and let me know whether you have understood this concept. And from Monday, we'll begin with textbook questions. But still, I request you, don't be dependent on the teacher to give you solutions. What is important? Understanding the concept is more important than looking for the solution. The questions may get changed for your exam. In that case, what will you do? So be tricky, be technical, be very much clear with your understanding of the concept. So here we understood that if you have questions on addition, subtraction, comparison, you will first take the LCM, then compare the numbers with the given, and then after comparing it with LCM, you will see they are now in equivalent form. And then those answers what you get are again surprisingly in like term, and simply write down those like terms and do the operation whatever is asked in the question. So please do tell me whether you have understood this, and please try to solve some questions on your own and show me. God bless you.